Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, Minds & Money 2018 London. And my second interview partner here comes from Zambia, ZCCM Investment Holdings. And Dr. Pius Kazolo wants to talk about, of course, Zambia and his holdings to us. Good morning, Pius.
Good morning.
And yeah, thanks for taking the time. It's really interesting because a company like you are, we have not had so far at Commodity TV. And maybe you explain shortly what is ZCCM doing? What are you about?
ZCCM Investment Holdings is a diversified investment company. We have invested near 90% of our investments are in mines. We own shares ranging from about 10% to about 100% in Zambian mines, both copper, gold, and copper and cobalt. But we have also got investments in energy. We got an investment in a power generation company, a thermal power generation company called Mamba Collieries, 300 megawatts, and we are going to increase to 600 megawatts.
Uh-huh. That's also in Zambia?
That's also in Zambia, but we're also energy distributors, we distribute energy to the mines. That's CEC investment, and all the mines are distributed by CEC. Mm-hmm. Then we've got CEC Africa, which is also in Nigeria. We're also part of that.
Uh-huh. Nigeria is oil and gas, or what is that?
Yeah, but no, but we are in energy. We're in
energy
in Nigeria.
Yeah, of course.
Then on top of that, we have invested in a local bank. Mm-hmm. We own a local bank, 71% of a local bank, mm-hmm. Indigenous Zambian Bank.
Uh-huh.
And also we have vast property portfolio. So we have a total property.
Fantastic.
But our major investments is mining and energy.
Yeah, perfect. As you are the CEO of the company, of course, the question is, how large is the portfolio dollar-wise? Can you say that?
Yeah, we are between $1 and $2 billion capitalization.
Okay.
We are listed in Lusaka.
That would be my next question, yeah.
Yeah, listed in London.
Yeah.
And we are also listed in Paris.
Mm-hmm. And you are paying dividends?
Yes, we pay good dividends.
Oh, really?
What's the yield? One of the biggest dividend we've paid is $40 million.
Yeah.
And last year we also paid another $30 million, and this year we're paying another good dividend as well.
Okay, wow, super. That's important for investors,
Because our investors smile all the time.
I believe that, absolutely. Yeah. No, that's fantastic, because in an almost 0% interest world, especially here in Europe and also in the UK, a dividend is very favorable. Yeah. Yeah. What I'm interested in, because we know very well Zimbabwe, for example. Yeah. We know what happened there. Now we see the tensions in South Africa, honestly, which scares me a little bit, what is going on there. Maybe can you comment a little bit on that? What is going on the African continent? Because you are so commodity rich. You have so many resources. I mean, to me, it's one of the richest continents still in the world, but it looks to me like it lacks organization.
Well, yes and no. We have to look at the history of Africa.
Yeah.
We had, the settlers come in and basically, took land and explored minerals and things like that. So the people, I think they're all with a digital network where people can read and understand. So people are feeling aware to say, listen, we've got all these minerals, but there's nothing to show for it. So you get all these movements coming in and say, no, you have to share the minerals and understand that that has to be done.
Yeah.
And as an investor as well, we've got what they call CSR in Zambia. So where we exploit our minerals, we also give back to the people. Mm-hmm. We drill for water, for free water for them. Mm-hmm. We've done medical equipment. We have given to the hospitals.
Mm-hmm.
And those are the things we do. So people see that in spite of us investing and mining, we're also putting back to the people. Yes, with regard to land appropriation in South Africa and Zimbabwe, I believe we can do it much better than they're doing it. So what we can do is, negotiate, willing buyer, willing seller, and just be a win-win situation. Because if the farmers feel they're hard done, they'll leave the country, there will be no farming. And at the same time, if the local people feel they're hard done, there also be riots and things like that. So it has to be a win-win situation.
Absolutely, yeah, that's for sure. Coming back to your investments in your company, you said copper, cobalt, I mean, those are the battery metals for sure. They are in high demand, they are in a deficit, and you said you are doing thermal energy. Any other metals you think in the future you might be interested in?
Yeah, we have invested in manganese.
Ah, interesting. So it's manganese, also battery metals.
Yeah, we're doing a huge investment in manganese. We've drilled quite a lot for manganese. And also, as you know, there's also a bit of lithium in some of the places.
Ah, okay.
We're exploring for that.
Uh-huh.
And those are the minerals we're looking at. You know, yeah. The cobalt, lithium, manganese.
Mm-hmm.
Those are the energy battery making minerals.
Okay.
Those are the things we're looking. Those are the minerals for the future.
Absolutely.
Including copper. Copper is expanding.
Yeah.
The price went up very well last year and the beginning of this year. At the moment, it has kind of gone down, but it's going to stabilize.
Yeah, but it comes back.
It's going to stabilize,
I see it the same way. Mm. And now you've invested, like, of course, in Zambia, you said Nigeria, maybe probably a little bit in South Africa also. But the point is, do you want to extend that over Africa? Or you are, let's put it that way, you stay on the African continent with new investments?
No. We are an international company. We are listed in London.
Yeah.
So wherever a chance comes, we put money in. And, we cash liquid. We don't have a debt on our balance sheet.
Mm-hmm.
My investment is I invest off balance sheet.
Yeah,
and that's the entity borrows, the entity runs it itself, and we accumulate I think dividends from them.
Yeah.
So it's a clean way of investing.
Yeah.
And wherever somebody comes, we'll be Mongolia, whatever it will be, if it's a good project.
Yeah,
I'm going to invest.
Ah, perfect, perfect. So that leads me to the question, the DRC, Democratic Republic of Congo.
Mm.
I think 62% of the cobalt in the world comes out of that.
Yeah.
Is that something you would go there, or can you comment a bit on the country itself and on the cobalt maybe?
We, in Zambia, we also got cobalt. So between Zambia and DRC, we supply about 80% of the world cobalt. So we still got prospects of cobalt in Zambia. We are looking at them. And of course, if the chances occur in the DRC, I'm going to invest in DRC. We are neighbors.
Yeah.
We even supply energy to the DRC. So it's just a business as usual every day.
Okay, super. Yeah. Well, perfect. Thank you very much for the interview. That's an interesting insight. Yes, do you want to add something?
No, I'm just saying if you are to investment in Zambia or in Africa, please, we are the channel for investment. We know the continent. We know Zambia so well.
Yeah, you're the experts.
So if you want to, don't reinvent the wheel. The wheel is already there. The wheel is SSCM. So come and have a chat with us.
Perfect. We really have to regulate that.
Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Pius.
Okay.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Yeah, ladies and gentlemen, that was Dr. Pius Kasole, the CEO from ZCCM Investments. And as Pius really elaborated to, they are the experts for Africa, of course, with investments in Zambia, also maybe in the DRC soon, as he elaborated to. Cobalt, copper, manganese are the top metals. They do also geothermal. And they are also investing in energy in Nigeria. So I think a very interesting portfolio, and between $1 and $2 billion dollars is the holding value here. And they are listed in London, actually, here at your home exchange. So check out the company. Thanks for watching us. And don't forget, they pay a dividend. That's also important. Bye-bye from London.